Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today I will show you how we can create a perfect game. Like when we click the mouse, our ball hit these things. Now first I will show you how it can works. Now when I drag the mouse, when I press the mouse, you see that my ball health is increased and it hit these sprites perfectly. This is how we can create a simple game by clicking the simple mouse. If we press the mouse, it will increase the health of our ball. Then it will show you how much time we press the mouse button down and then we leave the mouse button, it hits our woods. Now if I press a button less power, then it will not go anywhere. If I press the button a long time, it will hit hard on these words. Now I will show you how I can make it simple. I am using the simple grass sprite and I am use the box collider 2D on it because it is 2D game. You can also apply it on 3D game. A simple ball that contain circle collider and a rigid body 2D, and I increase the mass of ball 49 and a gravity scale 20 and a ball script that I will show you next. Now these wood sprite that are used for that are blocks. In these blocks I am using simple box collider 2D and a rigid body 2D. The mass of these blocks are 1 and gravity scale is 10, and these are the simple balls. And a simple force that sprite that is used to show the how we press the mouse button, how long we press the mouse button, and a mask that is used to hide this sprite, and simple colliders on the sides of these scene that are simple collider with the box collider 2D and sprites with box collider 2D and simple scripts for this. Now I will first show you the ball script that I have already created and drag and drop it on the ball. In this script I will show you how it works. First I create a serialized private transform force form. It means that how long we press the mouse button and how force is applied on our ball that will move toward the mouse position, and a simple sprite for the mask of this. In awake I am using force sprite marks that will get the mask of our sprite and hide it, and this is the function that I have created to hide the sprite when we leave the mouse. In a simple update method I am get the force transform that we have already created and get the position of our mouse button. Now in vector 2 I am create a simple direction that we get from camera dot main that dot screen toward point, in which we get the input mouse position where we click our mouse, and when we leave the mouse we should minus it from the position and normalize it. That is the normalize function of Unity. Force transform dot evaluate angles. These angles are used to move when we click on our ball and move the mouse, the force is also move with our mouse, and get angular drag from vector float, and we should give this direction, this direction to our get angular from vector float. This is a function that I have created. I will show you that function, and then I will create a simple constant float max force, that is 500. Its value is 500, and this is the height force, this function that I have created. And for this I am simple use a force sprite dot alpha to equals to 1. It means that when we leave the mouse, the our force sprite will hide down. And this is the launch function that we have used to launch our ball. Simple, I am using a simple float variable with force. In this I am get the vector to direction and the camera that we have already created, this, and simple get the mouse position and then normalize it and multiply it with minus 1f. It means that when we leave the mouse, it will normalize it and multiply with minus 1 to the negative side. If we press the mouse button on negative side, it will multiply with minus 1, or if we press the leave the mouse button cursor on positive side, then it will also multiply it with minus 1 and normalize it. And then we get the transform component of it by 2D and apply the velocity in the direction and multiply with force. Direction is where we went to hit our or move our ball, and then the this force that is created in float value that we get from the this float value. And height force, height force is simply this function that we are used to hide our sprite mask, that is when we click the mouse button and it will increase the health of our ball. And that is the show force, where we when we click our mouse button, then it will increase the force, it will increase the health of our ball, and divide minus force division by max force. Max force is a function that we are used. This is a simple max force that we are applied on our ball. And the next, the angular from vector float, this function that we have used in this method. This is a simple function in which we get the direction and normalize it, and float number of value, and we are use the simple math app dot attan to function that get the direction of ball in y and x and multiply it with math app dot red to dev. This function is used to move our cursor, and when we rotate our cursor or move our cursor, our health bar is also move in the direction of our cursor. And simply return the and if our float value is less than 0, it will increase our angle to 360, and simply return that. This is a simple, and I will show you how it can work. Now simply when I run the game, you see that when I rotate our mouse, the health of our ball is also rotated in the direction of our ball. And when we leave it, the health of our ball is hide, and our ball move in the opposite direction of our mouse and hit the these things. And the second script I am using, this is a simple, I am create a simple test of the empty object and drag and drop simple a ball hit script on it. And this script simple private ball force, in which we get the ball, that this ball force, and get the reference of this ball force. And simple hold down start time. In this we are simply get the start time when we click down our mouse, or when we press the mouse down, the start time is noted in this float variable. In update method, we are use the input dot get mouse button down 0. When we place the click on right button, it will get the start time of our clicking. When we click on the screen, it will get the start time when we click our mouse button with using simple time dot time. This is get the current time when we click on the mouse on our screen. In second method, if input dot get mouse button down, in this we are use simple get mouse button down to get the mouse will still down. It means that when we pressing the mouse and cannot leave it, this function is run and we simply hold the down time with time dot time minus hold start, in which we are simply minus the hold time from the current time. And ball force, in this is a function which we are used to throw our ball to the scene and hit to the objects. Show force, this is a simple calculate hold down force with hold down time, that is a function. And in up mouse, we simply when we leave or launch our mouse, it will also get the calculation of our ball launch and increase the ball speed. In this simply we are use the calculate hold down mouse button in float value, and maximum force hold down time is 2f. It means that when we press the our mouse button down for 2 seconds, it will automatically add the force 500 maximum force that we have created in this scripts ball force scripts. So then we are simply create a force hold time normalize button normalize method that is use mathf.clamp 01 that get the hold time when we press the time and divide by maximum force hold down time, the maximum force that we are used in this in the ball force. And float force, this is the simple hold time normalized force with this is the force and with multiply with ball force dot max force that we are get this ball force script and get the function of get the force of maximum force from this script and multiply with our force and return the force. Simply you have attached these two scripts to our ball. First you should use this script ball force, this script is attached to our ball force, and then we should drag and drop this force to our force transform so that we can show our show the maximum health of our ball on the screen. And simply in test I am using a simple ball hit script that script is used get the simple ball script from our ball and get the maximum force of our ball. This is a simple game you can create easily and use in our in your games. I will provide these two scripts for you. If you have any question, you can ask me freely. Now I will again give you a simple response that how it can work. When I simply click on the mouse, if I click the mouse with less than 2 seconds, it will not go to higher. When I click the mouse greater than for 2 seconds and our my mouse is pressed down, it will increase the ball force and hit with high force on our sprite. In this way you can create many types of game and use these scripts in your games. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel and share this video.